Yeah, you guys have to stay quiet.
What?
Yeah, work out your hand signals. Welcome to Hump Day Hymns. My name is Mike McCormick. I am the music director here at Trinity St. Andrew's United Church in Renfrew, Ontario. We have a super extra special episode today because my guest is Lisa Weber, who lives in the bustling metropolis of Arnprior. We have somehow managed to get over the Renfrew-Arnprior rivalries, if only for, 40 minutes or so, and then we'll be bashing each other. Lisa is a singer, a singing teacher, all around vocal. She's a leads choir. She leads musical theater. Basically, if you've heard anyone sing well in this area, Lisa probably had a hand in it. So when I contacted her to be part of this, she wanted to know what she should sing, I just sort of said, well, we'd like you to sing what you like. But if it had any sort of churchy tie-in, that would be great too. And so Lisa came with this content, and how did that happen?
Well, when I thought about my church background, the first thing that came to mind was CGIT. So I was a big CGIT girl, and where I grew up in Lethbridge, our church was the largest group that there was in the province at that time. So I have huge memories and great songs and everything about CGIT. So I started in grade 7, went all the way through to grade 12. You stayed with your same leader the whole way.
Oh, okay.
And
so it's not like brownies or something where you go from a brownie to a guide to a something
no,
like that.
No, but Explorers. Explorers,
oh, okay.
Is the first.
Right.
When I don't remember. I think that's grade 4 to 6. So Explorers was first, and then you launch into CGIT in grade 7. And
okay.
you stick there till grade 12. And I really wanted to be a brownie because I loved the brownie. Brownie uniform.
And the cookies.
but I didn't get to be in brownies.
Oh,
my
sorry.
Mom, we went through the Explorer and CGIT groups instead. So, and that's where I learned to play guitar. I learned all my sing-along leadership skills, and that's how I came up with the theme.
Excellent. So how does this start at first? You've broken this up into sort of sections.
I did that because when I think about all the songs that I learnt at CGIT, there were certain parts of my upbringing through CGIT that led me to the section. So of course there's camp. Camp was huge. We went to Canyon Church Camp in Waterton every year, and that was a huge draw for everybody. So I learnt a lot of songs there. But then we had opening meetings. So meetings every Tuesday night, and then our opening always started with songs and prayers. So I learned a lot through there. CGIT has a real tradition of Vesper services. So
okay.
Vesper is a service that we held at Christmas time, and the girls, everybody took part in it.
Okay.
So that's another.
All right. Yeah. So let's start some singing.
Okay.
Okay.
So the first one we're going to do is, again, I remember this through Explorers and CGIT. We'd start every meeting. This is My Father's World. This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world, I rest me in the thought of rocks and trees, of skies and seas, His hand the wonders wrought. This is my Father's world, the birds their carols raise, the morning light, the lily white, declare their Maker's praise. This is my Father's world, He shines hear him pass. He speaks to me everywhere. This is my Father's world. Oh, let me ne'er forget that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the Then the next one we're going to do is also for CGIT, was a classic all round, whether it was weekly meetings or camp. So we're going to do It Only Takes a Spark to Get a Fire Going.
What a wondrous time is spring, when all the trees are budding, the birds begin to sing, the flowers start their blooming. That's how it is with God's love. Once you've experienced it, you want to sing. Fresh like spring, you want to pass it on.
I wish for you, my friend, this happiness that I found. You can depend on him. It matters not where you're. Shout it from the mountain top. I want my world to know the Lord of love has come to me. I want to pass it on.
So that has a tie in to our church, because that's in the hymn book we use now. Slightly different words that I probably fumbled on. And this is the first song I played when I was, hired for this job.
Okay.
So it was the musical director at the time, Bev. She said, "Oh, wouldn't it be great if you came in the week before and we had a big reveal and then you came up and played something." And I said, "Okay, can we make it something that I know?"
And this
rather than, "Here's Mike and he's gonna play it." Welcome, you're in good hands. So yeah.
Well, so they brought it back.
It's all good.
Good.
Okay. This one's just you, I think.
I think it is.
Excellent.
So, maybe I'll just mention that.
So is it camp time? We're in camp now?
We're in camp time. This one was really popular, of course, at the time, and Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. But it's it was through CGIT that I also learned that, campfire sing-along guitar. When I started in grade 7, I did take lessons at that time, but I was doing classical guitar. The senior girls, there was quite a lot that they sang and they played guitar, and I wanted to be like that. And so I learned. Make me a channel of
cast out true faith in you. Make me a channel. Despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Spirit, grant that I may never see. Consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel.
So this next one is called Joy is Like the Rain. And I have memories standing at the foot of the mountains, you know, at camp. And this was one of my favorites. It has four verses, and they really, they really tell the story. So when you're around all the nature and just using guitar or just your voices, it really left a memory.
I saw raindrops on my window. Joy is like the rain. Laughter runs across my pain, slips away and comes again. Joy is like the rain. I saw clouds upon a mountain. Joy is like a cloud. Always sun or sometimes gray. Always sun not far away. Joy is like a cloud. I saw Christ in wind. Asleep within my boat, whipped by wind yet still afloat. Joy is tried by storm. I saw raindrops on my window. Joy is like the rain. Bit by bit the
that song, also singing it near the mountains, only it was the Hamilton Mountain, and we were on top of the mighty peak of the Hamilton Mountain, singing down towards the valley people, who we'll talk about later.
Maybe not quite as joyful as, Waterton. Okay. So the next one that I chose was Morning is Broken, And ours is, you know, maybe a little more folk style. Because look, we had to grab out the songs for a gospel people. That's what I grew up on at the United Church, and we picked a lot from this.
Yeah, window. Really.
Okay, so this, when I was brainstorming all the songs we could possibly do, I had like two pages, but I chose for us to do a round that, I'm sure in, Girl Guides and Boy Scouts, they maybe do this one too, but for CGIT, it would always end our campfire.
Okay.
And again, there's a real art to be, leading people in sing-alongs, and
absolutely.
I think that it was here that I really gained that confidence. You'd get half the, the little logs were all around the fire, and okay, you get that log and I'll get this log.
Okay.
And so we would lead.
Okay, so this is a round, so everyone at home, you can sing your part, and the tech crew as well. If you know this one, you can join in as well.
Fire's burning, fire's burning, draw nearer, draw nearer. In the gloaming, come sing and be merry. Fire's burning, fire's burning, draw
fire's
nearer,
burning,
draw
fire's
nearer.
Burning,
in the gloaming,
nearer,
in the gloaming,
nearer,
come
the
sing
gloaming,
and be fire's burning, fire's burning, draw nearer, draw nearer. In the gloaming, in the gloaming, come sing and be merry.
Come sing and be merry. Oh, I could hear them at home.
I think I could too. I think I could too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Excellent.
Again, well, you got to close this on your own then.
That's right. So again, we had tradition at the either the end of the day or the end of camp. I remember singing taps. So we did. Day's done, gone the sun, from the lakes, from the hills, from the sky, all is well, safely rest, God is nigh. And then we would leave the circle quietly. So that's my...
Nice.
Yeah.
So how are you doing?
Well, I'm doing all right. You know.
So when the whole COVID thing happened, that would have been kind of the height of your season, would it not?
It really was. It was just, well, I remember the fateful day being Friday the 13th, March 13th is when everything kind of closed, both in my studio and choir. But choir, it was interesting. We do, so the Arnprior Community Choir does a March concert, and we got that in. So March 8th, it was, I'm so happy that we did get that in, along with the Valley Concert Band.
Right.
But, so we did have at least one, you know, concert that we were able to do. After that, though, I was winding up for my students doing Renfrew Music Festival.
Yeah, which is like end of April.
Yeah, end of April. So we were picking that. I was picking songs for RCM exams. So
right.
I was working, I had a good handful doing June exams.
Okay.
Then there's auditions for university kids were doing.
Right.
So it really, everything just, stopped. It was...
And at this point, do you know what the fall is going to look like, or is that still, you're still juggling that?
Still juggling, but the choir is, we're launching a fall season.
Okay.
But it will be all online.
Okay.
And I have to say, it isn't singing. We're not rehearsing. Our intention is not to do a virtual choir recording or anything like that.
Okay.
But our choir, we are 80 plus people, and they miss it desperately, desperately.
Sure.
And so our goal is just to stay connected.
Right.
You know, so we're going to launch this fall season and hopefully just see faces and keep us strong so that when we can come back together, we'll be still a choir. Students, it will be online in the fall. But
and have you done any of the online lessons so far?
Yeah, I have.
And
it took me a little bit to launch into feeling comfortable with Zoom, but I'm using Zoom. And surprisingly, it actually works well, but in a different way.
Yeah.
It's, you know, you can't sing together. And at the studio, a big part of lessons for my students are singing with me. We sing duets, we sing trios, and so we can't do that.
Yeah.
And so it's a lot of, I'm sending you by email the notes.
Right.
And then you learn it, and we work on it that way. For more senior students, actually, it's a really interesting tool. You can be really technical and get at things you would never see.
So, you know, you might find some positives out of that, hopefully.
Yeah.
So let's do a little more background. You're from Southern Alberta.
Southern Alberta.
It sounds like the CGIT was as much a big part of your kind of musical background as anything else. Like you took some guitar lessons. Did you take singing lessons?
I took singing lessons when I was in, kind of started in high school. We started, you know, about grade 10.
Okay.
And there's a shout out to Sandy Brunel.
Sandy
so,
Brunel.
Sandy, I started singing lessons, but it was very...
She's watching, I know. I know
she is going to watch because I'm going to tell her to watch.
Okay.
But we were, we worked, I really didn't do exam work or I didn't even audition for university with voice.
Oh, okay.
I was doing singing because I was in a really strong jazz choir.
Oh, okay.
At high school. So that's where I really was taking my singing and did guitar and mostly did classical guitar and took from the university, Dale Ketchison, And but then I realized I loved singing, you know, and I really gravitated to performing in singing.
So you went to music, like, in Alberta?
Yep, I went to U of L, University of Lethbridge.
Another shout out.
Yeah.
What's the U of L's nickname? What are they? Are they the...
Pronghorns.
Pronghorns.
Ooh, ooh.
Go Pronghorns.
Go Pronghorns.
So you got into the school doing guitar.
I did guitar. And I started Bachelor of Music and Bachelor of Education. So it's a combined degree.
Okay.
And it was probably midway into the first year that I switched to singing. I have so many shout outs because I had a fabulous voice teacher who became my choral mentor, Dr. George Evelyn. And George was so positive and he was really nurturing to his students. And so I switched, to voice. So I got my double degree there.
Okay.
And in Alberta, we do all the grades for teaching. So we didn't have to specify elementary or high school. I did enjoy junior high and high school, but even still, you could teach any grade. So I finished at a Christmas time, and I remember I wanted to do my master's. So I had time, and I took what they'd call now LTO. I took a term doing a string program. Maybe you didn't know that.
I did not know
that. Okay, well, so I did. It was a string program, an itinerant string program. So Alberta has fabulous music education. And when I grew up, you know, all music specialists. And so my cello and I went from school to school. And it was in an area like this in a school. And we would just set up and it would be a string program. So I did that before I came.
So much easier to travel as a vocalist than as a cellist.
Yeah. Yeah.
So how does a girl from Southern Alberta end up in Arnprior?
Okay.
Somewhere there's got to be a transition there.
Exactly.
Two time zones.
I auditioned for master's programs, and so I came out and auditioned at several schools, and I knew as soon as I got to Ottawa that I loved it. Loved Ottawa. So beautiful. And the program at the time when I started it, I was either the first year when it started the second. It was really new. And it was excellent. My teacher, Ingemar Corius, he was fabulous. And my transition between George and Ingemar was great. He just took me under his wing and really developed there.
Okay.
So, and then I got married and we came to Arnprior. And started a family. And it was great. I felt I always had the best of both worlds because Arnprior is so close to Ottawa.
Right.
That at the time when I was before kids, I could still do Cantata Singers of Ottawa. I could still do church singing. I sang at Rideau Park United Church for years. Yeah, so I could do in and
out. When did you start the choir?
Right when I came.
Okay.
So when I moved to Arnprior, they had a night school. So ADHS had a night school.
Okay.
So choir was, you know, on the docket with bridge and oil painting.
And auto shop.
Yeah. Yeah. So we started it.
All in one room.
And it went from eight singers. I think it was 8 to 10 singers the first term. Yeah, with no music, and then all of a sudden the word got out and that there was a choir. Arnprior had church choirs and excellent programs that way, but there was never a community choir. So it really took off. We doubled and then we tripled.
Each time along the way, that would probably lead to its own problems, finding places to play, someone to accompany.
We've run the gamut of using all the possible halls in Arnprior. So we went from schools, we went to a sanctuary of a church, we were at the Galilee downstairs for a long time, and then we finally found our home at the Legion. because it's one floor. It's very easy for us. It's right. nice and bright, you know, so yeah. we can all see our music. Not a lot of stairs.
There's a bar at the back.
Yeah, it's win-win. It's a win-win.
It's, you know, yeah.
Yeah, but it's grown over the years, and where, you know, I always say one of the things in Arne Prior that's maybe a little tricky for me is establishing really good connections with accompanists, because there are many in the area, and of course, a lot to draw on from Ottawa, but do they want to drive to the Valley and make that commitment all the time? So yeah. we've really been really lucky with who we've had for accompanists.
Right.
Yeah, so it's excellent.
Cool. So, I mean, so we've talked about, you know, where you came from, what and what's also in the fall. I mean, are there other things you've been doing musically? Are you still singing in Ottawa, or do you get calls from there?
Not anymore.
No.
I'm sorry. Well, you know, for a long time, I did a lot of oratorio singing and mm-hmm. was a soloist in many groups. And called back, you know, a lot. Now there's lots of young singers, and right. now there's a lot of, and I think for me at this stage, I really am a teacher. I love teaching, I love singing too, but I like doing other things. And so I'm really not ready to commit to my evenings.
Right.
You know, if I was to do a run of a show or an opera or a choir in Ottawa, it really...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
so
hard.
It's a big, you know, commitment.
Yeah, it is.
But so do you live vicariously through your students now? Like you've got students all over the country now.
I do.
All over North America, don't you?
I do. I go on Facebook and I'm like, you know, all these people doing, it's excellent. You know, I've got students doing Broadway in Toronto. I've got out east, and you know what's. I've got a young girl that's heading to Yale for her master's. I think the proudest is not only those that go on in music, because that really is amazing to me, but those that I think find singing lessons, even takes them through, you know, interviews and
right.
I have a girl who's the clerk, the town clerk at the Arne Prior Town Hall.
Okay.
And just watching her speak the meetings and it, that singing makes a difference.
Right.
You know, and I think that's what's really
yeah,
cool.
Absolutely. All right, speaking of singing, we should sing some more.
Yes. Okay. So this next, I guess, section. We've got two songs that we're going to do, and this is my memory of Vesper services. So again, if you can picture over 100 girls participating in the okay. Christmas service, and we had an ending to the service where we would surround the church, and it would start a cappella and very soft with Let There Be Peace on Earth, and we all had a candle. It was a flashlight covered okay, with tissue yeah, paper yeah, that we
same,
all made.
Same difference.
So, same difference. Yeah. So, and then we would light it, and then the church would be surrounded with candlelight, and then we'd finish with I Am the Light of the World. So we're going to start with Let There Be Peace.
On earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. Harmony. Let peace. this be my solemn vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Oh, now I've forgotten how we're...
So you're going to give me a chord?
I'm good.
I am the light of the world. You people come and follow me. If you follow and love, you'll learn the mystery of what you were meant to do and be. When the song of the angels is still, the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and the shepherds have found their way home, the work of Christmas is begun. I am the light of the world. You people come and follow me. If you follow in love, you'll learn the mystery of what you were meant to do and be. Hungry children with warmth and good food, to fill the earth below the sky above. I am the light of the world. You people come and follow me. If you follow in love, you'll learn the mystery of what you were meant to do and be. To free the prisoner from chains, to make the powerful care, to rebuild the nations with strength of goodwill, to see God's children everywhere. I am the light of the world. You people come and follow me. If you follow in love, you'll learn the mystery of what to bring hope to every task you do, to dance at a baby's new birth, to make music in an old person's heart, and sing to the colors of the earth. I am the light of the world. You people come and follow me.
To the reception and
Kool-Aid and cookies.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Okay, I love this next song. I tried for a while to convince my daughter to sing it, fairly unsuccessfully. So,
well, I hope when she hears our version, she would like to sing it. So, you know, I did a little background check of the original group that sang this.
Yes.
And so we're going to sing One Tin Soldier. And lo and behold, I don't think I knew this at the time. Maybe I did and I've forgotten. The original cast was formed in Calgary.
Really?
Really. So a folk trio formed in Calgary, 1966. So maybe that, I just thought it was the time frame it became really popular.
So this is like the Southern Alberta double shot here.
I guess. Know that. Yeah, one of the members sang on Calgary Safety Roundup.
Okay.
And I do remember that show on TV.
Calgary Safety Roundup. What was that?
Well, I don't know. I'd have to look back.
Oh, see we.
But
had...
it featured, okay. You know. Yeah.
See, in Ontario, we had a safety elephant.
All right.
Elmer the safety element. I've been prompted by the tech crew, but I don't think he sang. Elmer never sang. No one gave him a chance to sing. Okay,
oh,
so the Calgary safety hour.
Roundup, yes.
Sorry, of course. It's
Calgary.
It's Calgary, yes. Okay.
Right. So this song is
really
always.
Ruined the mood of this song.
This song was always a favorite, and I do remember just the words, the text, all of that. Listen, children, to a story that was written long ago about a kingdom on a mountain and the valley folk below. On the mountain was a treasure buried deep beneath a stone. And the valley people swore they'd have it for their very own. Go ahead and hate your neighbor. Go ahead and cheat a friend. Do it in the name of heaven. You can justify it in the end. There won't be any trouble. It's blowing, come the judgment day, on the bloody morning after. One tin soldier rides away. So the people of the valley sent a message up the hill, asking for the buried treasure, tons of gold for which they'd kill. Came an answer from the kingdom, with our brothers we will share all the secrets of our mountain, all the riches buried there. Go ahead and hate your neighbor. Justify it in the end. There won't be any trumpets blowing. Come the judgment day, on the bloody morning after, one tin soldier rides away. Your horses, draw your sword, and they killed the mountain people. Sure, they'd won their just reward. Now they stood beside the treasure on the mountain, dark and red. Turned the stone and looked beneath it. Peace on earth was all it said. Go ahead and hate your neighbor. Go ahead and cheat a friend. Do it in the name of heaven. You can justify it in the end. There won't be any trumpets blowing. Come the judgment day, on the bloody morning after. Tin soldier rides away. That just gets you, that song. Oh, okay, and another
Classic of classic. The Alberta canon.
Yes. So very popular with the CGIT group.
Wow.
If we ever had requests, this was one of them.
This is the first one? Okay.
Yes. For strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But the good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you. Weather's good there in the fall. I got some friends that I can go to work and for. Still, I wish you'd change your mind if I asked you one more time. But we've been through that 100 times. Strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But the good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you. If things are going good, you could meet me if I sent you down the fair. But by then it would be winter, not too much for you to do, and those winds sure. Strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But the good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for
So here's my little bit of trivia on this song. Apparently, okay. That's the first song Ian Tyson ever wrote.
Oh, the first one he wrote.
Yeah.
Okay.
So after that, would you bother writing a second?
I know.
Like, what are you going to do now?
How do you top that?
What do you got for us now, Ian? Can you write that one again?
Okay. So the other thing I just wanted to, we're just coming to the end with how we used to end our CGIT services, but I just, the other thing I did want to say that I think it's through CGIT that I got I honed my skills to develop a really meaningful service or a program. So when I do a student recital, when I do a fundraiser concert or the choir concert, I realize after doing this program today that that's where I got it from.
Yeah.
You know, variety and building verses.
Right.
Surrounding the church, you know, so that it gives people in the audience an experience.
Yeah. It's a real skill and an art.
Yeah. 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 So I kind of think, often I use, I think it was my university days and my education and, you know, that brought that, but yeah. I think really it started with this.
We've reawakened that in
you. Yes, you have.
All right, so this would be the close of
Yes, we closed a lot of services, more church services and maybe our weekly services. We didn't sing it so much at camp, but
okay. Yeah. I think everyone at TSA will recognize the first one.
Right. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him all creatures here below. Praise him above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And then we often led into the go now in peace, which we'll do today as a round.
So okay.
Mike knows this one.
Be ready to sing. But before we get into that, I'd like to thank you again, Lisa, for coming and sharing with us a little taste of Southern Alberta CGIT. Yeah. And I feel bad. I forgot to bring a piece of rope to see whether you could still tie your sail or not.
Okay, do you know what? Oh, I'm so glad you said this because my husband, Rick, who's out there maybe watching, who went through the trials and tribulations yesterday with me, learning again, reigniting the sailor's knot.
Okay.
So, you know, Mike, just for you, and I knew, I panicked because I know you. And when you heard about how we had to do the sailor's knot,
here we go.
I thought he is going to ask.
Okay,
and I'm
here
just
we go.
Fail.
Sailor's knot. Here.
Okay,
here we
so
go.
So it's a friendship knot.
Friendship
that we always
knot.
Had to do. I probably left it tied from grade 7 to 12 but I know now how to do it.
That's so. What I would have done.
Just wait.
I got to
do this better.
Are we zoomed in? Are we getting the close up on this? Okay.
It's going to go well. I know it.
Okay.
Look at it. And I think I got it. Oh, wait. Okay, calm down.
Okay.
So right over left.
Right over left.
Is there look anything? Over.
The bunny goes through that.
There, I got it. My hands are all tied, but I got it.
There it is.
And there.
Bravo, bravo.
There it is. So with this around my neck.
You are ready.
Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you.
May the love of God surround you. Everywhere, everywhere you
may go. Go now in peace. Go now in peace.
Go now in peace.
Go now in peace.
May the love of God surround you. Everywhere.